wikiprocedure.com welcomes you for another session on how to apply for stage carriage permit in Tamil Nadu. The link provided here will help you in reaching our site wikiprocedure.com and the page Tamil Nadu apply for stage carriage permit. Here we have given the procedures, office address, eligibility criteria, fees involved, processing time, validity, other important instructions which will be helpful for you to complete this procedure. In this video, we will be giving you some hints about the sites which will be helpful in completing the procedure, are all provided as a link in our page at respective places for your convenience. Let us get into the presentation. List of items covered in this session: need for stage carriage permit, documents required, how to apply, eligibility, validity, online resources, fees, processing time, offices and contacts, other information. Need for stage carriage permit. First of all, stage carriage permit is something which will be useful for the vehicle which is meant for carrying passengers who will be waiting in a bus stop to enter the vehicle, and the vehicle person, conductor, may charge fare for a place where they are getting down. Usually these kind of stage operations will happen in the city or the town areas. We happen to travel in a private bus other than a government bus, where we will be paying a fare for shorter distance against the receipt which they give. It is called ticket. So the need for stage carriage permit arises with a requirement to operate trips in a route. Trips means the to or the fro, meaning from one place to another place is called trip, and coming back from that place to the origin is another trip. So in a route area for carrying passengers with the stages is nothing but stop. The stage carriage permit allows the holder to service in an area with a specific route. The permit also mentions the type of vehicle that is granted permission to operate, the approved timetable, the number of trips it can make in a day, and standard rate for a rate of fare it can charge. All the mentioned details are all prescribed in the permit as per the government norms, because the fare should not be different for different users. It should be unique. And the timetable means on what time the vehicle will approach those areas, and the route for which the permission is provided. So in a route they can provide permission for certain number of vehicle to pass by, the number of trips it can make on that particular route for per day is also given by the government for smooth running of any public transport utilities. Documents required. Application forms can be downloaded from the link provided below. The main application form SCPA can be downloaded from the site. I can show you the site and the form downloadable. So this is the site where you can download SCPA application form and start your procedure. Proof of address. Any one of the following has to be attached, like ration card, Aadhaar card, electoral roll, license policy, passport, payslip issued by government or local body, school certificate of the applicant, birth certificate of the applicant, affidavit sworn by the applicant before an executive or a first class judicial magistrate or notary public, registration certificate for the vehicle if the vehicle is a registered one, insurance certificate if the vehicle is a registered one, valid tags. Why we are telling registered one? A new vehicle which is coming along with the registration process also can be considered. Valid tax paid for the vehicle. Solvency certificate for 30,000 rupees as cautious deposit kind of word. And workshop facilities for maintaining the standard of the vehicle. Registration certificate of the vehicle. Insurance registration certificate for the vehicle. Insurance certificate for the vehicle. Pollution under control certificate issued by the authorities for the vehicle. Valid tax paid receipt for the receipt for the vehicle. Passport size photo, two numbers of the applicant are all the documents required for stage carriage permit. How to apply? To apply for a stage carriage permit in Tamil Nadu, the applicant has to approach his area RTO office. The same can be found out through the link provided here. This site will help you in finding out the RTO office of your area. So you can select the region where you belong, and from there you can find out the RTO office belongs to your area. And make sure you have completed the application form SEPA. The application form can be downloaded from the link provided below, as I explained. Also make sure you have all the necessary documents to process this application, because missing out one document will make you to stand in a position where your application get rejected. The applicant should make sure they are eligible for the process, because eligibility criteria are also important for the application's process. Application form can also be obtained directly from the RTO office where you go. You can fill the application form along with the document and submit it to the offices in the RTO office, where they will notify you the exact fees involved in getting this permit. You have to pay the fees and along with the documents and application form at the right counter to start your procedure. Once they receive the application, they start verifying and your process get workable. So you will get the stage carriage permit for your application. Eligibility: you should be the owner of the vehicle in order to apply for stage carriage permit. Validity: permit is valid for 5 years. The renewal of permit can be obtained with vehicle fitness certificate and FC as per the authorities of concerned RTO. As we spoke about a public transport vehicle, the government has certain regulation in order to safeguard the safety of the passengers who are general public who will be traveling in this vehicle. In view of that, they will always look into the outlook of the vehicle and also the working condition of the vehicle, all the pollution control fixtures, and also the speed limit of the vehicle. So these things will be taken care by this procedure by the authorities to safeguard the public interest. The age of the vehicle is also considered to restrict the validity of the permit. The age can be different for different types of vehicle, and this also can be obtained from the RTO office. Online resources: link for form and details as I provided here, it is all available here. The RTO contact is another site where you can get the RTO telephone numbers along with the address for your for clearing all your doubts with the authorities. Fees: permit fees is ₹1,500. For interstate route, it is 150 per state. Timing conference fees ₹600. Fees related information can be obtained from the following link. I will show you the link. This is a very important and useful link for the users, because it will provide all the services along with the fees involved, which will update you on beforehand to apply for this procedure. We have listed all the website here as link in appropriate place of our page in wikiprocedure.com to save your time. Processing time: it takes 5 working days to get the permit. Offices and contacts: your regional transport office RTO is the office for communication, and the contacts, office address and contacts, can be found out through the link. I have explained it to you. You can use that link to find out the address and contacts. Other information: the type of seating capacity of each such vehicle for stage carriage permit should be notified to the authorities. Yes. The number of passengers who can get accommodated in the vehicle has to be mentioned in the permit. FC, for clearance, is a process meant for reviewing the condition of the vehicle by the RTO authorities. Thank you once again for visiting wikiprocedure.com to know how to apply for stage carriage permit in Tamil Nadu. Thank you.